Siddharth, and today I am here with trigonometry part 6. I request you to watch all my trigonometry videos right from part 1 to understand it more. In the previous video, we have learnt about Pythagoras theorem, and now we are learning how to use Pythagoras theorem in trigonometry. The Pythagoras theorem states that in a right angle triangle, if C is the hypotenuse and A and B are its legs, then C square is equal to A square plus B square. Let us solve an example problem. We have to find all these trigonometric ratios from this trigonometric ratio. Here we know that tan theta is equal to opposite by adjacent. Let us write this fraction is equal to 8 by 15. In our new triangle, the opposite is 8 and the adjacent is 15. Let us draw a right angle triangle. Write an angle theta. The opposite is 8, so the side opposite to theta is 8. Adjacent side is 15. Here hypotenuse we have to find. We have to use Pythagoras theorem to find the hypotenuse. First we have to label the sides. Always we have to use C for labeling hypotenuse. And for the legs we use A and B. Let us substitute the values in Pythagoras theorem, which states C square is equal to A square plus B square. Here we have to find C, so we write it as it is. C square is equal to, here 8 is there, so we get 8 square. 8 square plus, here B is 15, so we get 15 square. C square is equal to, 8 square is 64 plus 15 square is 225. 64 plus 225 is 289. Here, C is equal to root 289 is equal to 70. Here, C is 70. Now, let us find sine theta. First, let us label the sides. The longest side in a triangle is hypotenuse. So, 17 is the hypotenuse. The side opposite to theta is opposite side. Here, 8 is the opposite side. And the remaining side is 15. So, 15 is the adjacent side. Now, we have a formula like sine theta is equal to opposite by hypotenuse is equal to, here 8 is the opposite and 17 is the hypotenuse. So, we write 8 by 17. Therefore, sine theta is equal to 8 by 17. Now, let us find cos theta. We have a formula like cos theta is equal to adjacent by hypotenuse is equal to, here the 15 is adjacent and 17 is the hypotenuse. So, we write 15 by 17. Therefore, cos theta is equal to 15 by 17. Now let us find cosecant theta. We have a formula like cosecant theta is equal to hypotenuse by opposite is equal to, here 17 is the hypotenuse and 8 is the opposite. So we get 17 by 8. Therefore cosecant theta is equal to 17 by 8. Now let us find secant theta. Here we have a formula like secant theta is equal to hypotenuse by adjacent is equal to, here 17 is the hypotenuse and 15 is the adjacent. So we write 17 by 15. Therefore, secant theta is equal to 17 by 15. Now let us find cot theta. We have a formula like cot theta is equal to adjacent by opposite is equal to, here 15 is adjacent and 8 is opposite. So we write 15 by 8. 15 by 8. So friends, here is the homework. Try these problems using the Pythagoras theorem and trigonometric ratios and check the answers. The answers are given in the description.